Car number 25 out of Nashville, Tennessee. And I got to ask this guy this. This is Roy Benkler from Nashville, Tennessee. What kind of you to Ray and Charlie?
They're my uncles.
How long have you been racing, Roy?
It's about my fourth year.
I don't know where you remember it, and you probably don't. But Charlie Benkler used to come down here in the car number 125, and he was virtually unstoppable. In fact, 1 year, maybe 2 years, he was undefeated at Huntsville Motor Speedway, one of the top runners of all time at Huntsville. And Roy, where do you normally race?
I run at Highland Rim Speedway, up here on Champions Track. It is my first time here in Huntsville. We're going to try to see if we can break Charlie's streak.
Going to have a tough go. Well, good luck. Roy Benkler out of Nashville, Tennessee. This guy drives a mean tow truck. I go home to Fayetteville each and every Friday night, and I'm cruising along at about 55, 60, 65, and they came by me each week like I was standing still. And one week I saw them, they had some blue lights behind them. I don't know what happened. But a fine runner and a beautiful race car out of Nashville, Tennessee, car number 72, Robert Wilson. No stranger to Huntsville Motor Speedway. Races with us each and every Friday night in the car number 17, the beautiful yellow and black Camaro from Huntsville, Alabama, Ernie Rivard.
Yeah.
Where is he? Here he is. One of our top runners in the limited sportsman division. Used to run in the street stock. Set out for a number of years. Started back in the limited division. And I think Fred Lane prepared this car for Jeff Harris this year. And Jeff won several feature events. Set a track record earlier in the season. And Jeff, what are you planning for next year? To race? Other than that. That's about it. Jeff Harris from Here's the Green Alabama. Car number 26. Car is formerly owned and driven by the brand new national champion in the Daytona Darlington Series. This is the car that Gary Wade Finley, and I don't know whether Gary Wade is here or not, but he sure deserves a fine round of applause for his national championship win in the Daytona Darlington Series. And this gentleman has purchased the Gary Wade Finley car. He's a former road racing champion in the car number 26 from Huntsville, Alabama, Leroy Cassingham. Leroy, you're going to run with us next year in the late model. Good luck today, and good luck next year. Leroy Cassingham. Here's a top runner. He's raced with us for a number of times. He finished second last night in the Southern All-Star Show at the Hardy-Dixie Speedway in Sayre, Alabama. He is a 1990-point champion at the Hardy-Dixie Sayre Speedway in car number 99 from Birmingham, Alabama, Gary Nick. Good luck, Gary. Another one of our top runners at Huntsville Motor Speedway in car number 10, the Cass Car Heating Air Conditioning car, for Chuck Tuck from Athens, Alabama. And Chuck would have to be the winner of our Hard Luck Award for the 1989 season. He has run so good to have so many problems. And Chuck, what are your plans for next year with us?
I'm running every race and not have a wreck.
Let's hope so. From Athens, Alabama, car number 10, Chuck Tuck. Car number 81, the Williams Service car, is the 1989 late model sportsman track champion, the NASCAR Winston track champion, been racing 3 years, and in his third year he won the track championship, and the late model division had a little problem in qualifying. He's back in the field. Tony Walls from Albertville, Alabama. Tony, you got a long ways to go.
Yeah, but it's a long race. Well, let's be patient and see what happens. We'll be here soon, and we'll have a chance.
Tony, I noticed the car was smoking a little in practice. Is that going to be a problem?
Well, I hope not. We've got a valve guy going bad on number 8, and maybe we can last 150 laps.
Good luck to Tony Wall. To some gentleman needs no introduction. He's out of Franklin, Tennessee. He's run ASA. He's run late model. He's won Winston Cup. He, of course, took over the ride for Bobby Allison in Winston Cup after Bobby was injured, only to be injured himself. Where we're looking for big things next year. From Franklin, Tennessee, Mike Alexander in the Turbo Blue, car number 84. As the season went on, this guy, after moving up to the late model division, got stronger. Stronger each and every week. In fact, almost won himself two or three features, only to have engine problems. Of course, last year, a lot of bad luck at the end of the season when he looked like he had the limited sportsman championship just about wrapped up. He had problems, then moved to the late model division, did a super job in the Jodeen Auto Parts car number 16 from Lacey Springs, Bruce Shaw. Got to be one of the prettiest race cars I've seen in a long, long time. Car number one is a 1990 Ford Probe automobile, one of the few Fords that race on the circuit at Huntsville Motor Speedway or any of the tracks. This car tonight, this afternoon, excuse me, driven by Chuck Chamley of A-Rab, Alabama. Car number one. Car number 102, one of our top feature winners, one of our top point men. In fact, he finished third this season at Huntsville Motor Speedway. His dad raced with us for a number of years, used to race on dirt. And of course, Jimmy Wall in the Country 102, one of our top runners, did a super job. Let's give him a good round of applause from Huntsville, Alabama. Good luck, Jimmy Wall. This gentleman works for Channel 48 TV, does a lot of filming production work for Channel 48. Car number 84, sponsored by Mindy's Enterprises, a very consistent top runner at Huntsville Motor Speedway. Car number 84 is David Northcutt. Car number 14 is my older brother. Is that right?
Not right.
Car number 14, the Lisa's Lounge car, prepared by Fred Lane of Huntsville, Alabama, driven by Dean Bentley from Readingville, Alabama. Good luck, Dean. Car number 6 is our 1987 and 1988 NASCAR Winston Point champion at Huntsville Motor Speedway and a close runner-up for the championship this year. Probably lost the championship when he was involved in an accident with a slow car that had been left 3 or 4 times, totaled his car out, had to buy a new car. Took him a long time to get it sorted out, but indeed he has got it sorted out. From Lacey Springs, Alabama, the Austin Hines, car number 6 for Ronald Wall. Special awards for our top 3 drivers. Tony Williams, with the many locations of Williams Service throughout North Alabama, is sponsoring prize money and special awards for the top 3 qualifiers. In the third position, our third fastest qualifier, he'll go off the inside second row. He is our top feature winner for the 89 season at Huntsville Motor Speedway. And car number 44, the Hines installation car for Dan Bedingfield. Dan, good luck. Car number 41, off the outside pole position. And I've got to talk to this guy about this, because for the last 2 races, he started on the pole position, and on the start, he's had problems. Mike Oliver from Gunnersville, Alabama, in the RD Electronics car. Mike, tell us about the start of this race.
Well, I'm not in the same position I thought I would be. Sometimes you get your wings clipped. I come to win today, and I'm still going to try to take the lead on the first lap, and if not, I got 150 more to try. I know Harold's running real strong today. The last time me and him started side by side on the front straightaway, I turned over in turn 3. So we may do that again. We'll just have to see what turns up.
Good luck to Mike Oliver. Now, for the fastest time of the afternoon and an all-time track record at 12.304 in the Tony Moore Buick Subaru GMC Cloverleaf Lincoln Mercury, car number 98 from Brent Mountain, Alabama. A good round of applause for Harold Lindley. Harold, I said Chuck Tuck probably will win the Hard Luck Award. You're going to be very close to it because you had an awful lot of hard luck. I know you came on late and the season very strong, and you won a feature event. And I understand that maybe you made an engine change 3 or 4 weeks ago. Is that correct?
Yeah, that's true. We've got a good crew now working on the car, and we've also got good engine people now working with it and trying to get some more horsepower, plus we need reliability more than anything. But we feel like we got a good combination now, but we ain't going to stop working here. We're going to have to continue working because everybody else is doing good, too.
Okay, Harold Lindley, our pole sitter.
don't have a fire extinguisher, back away from it. If you don't have an extinguisher, please back away from the automobile. Please. We need everyone back.
Thank you.
place for your front runner is 81. Tony Walls, Mike Alexander in 84, and the 44 car, Doug Batesville.
an effort to stay out of all the wrecks and the problems, and you could tell the car from the start was running with the leaders, and you stayed out of trouble, and by golly, you won your first late model race of your career, and it's the biggest race of the 89 season. I know you, your crew, and your sponsors feel real good about this.
Yeah, well, main thing you got to do is finish. So we finished first, so that's all it counts.
Who built your engine? Who did the engine build on our car, Bruce?
Dan Mitchell, Jerry Dane built the engine, Joe Dane, my father, Don Savage, Rich Hayes, Jimmy Love, Paul Landis, all my crew, Don Savage. Y'all keep it geared up. We just go to the front.
First win of his career in the late model division. He's won a lot of limited and a lot of street races. Bruce Shaw out of Lacey Springs, Alabama.